another episode of Heart to Palate. Today I'm going to share a recipe for butter chicken, which is all the kids love it, and my kids also, they relish this dish. So I'm going to start marinating the chicken first for the butter chicken. I've taken the chicken thighs, boneless thighs. You can always use a breast, that's fine too. I've taken about 3 pounds of chicken thighs, which I cut into like one inch cube pieces. To that I'm going to add 3 tablespoons of dahi or yogurt, 3 teaspoons of kasuri methi, 6 teaspoons of ginger garlic paste, 3 teaspoons of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of haldi, 3 teaspoons of dhana jeera powder, and 3 teaspoons of garam masala. So this is the marinade for the chicken, boneless chicken. We're going to marinate it and leave it aside. And in the meantime, we're going to make the gravy for it. And I'm going to show you how to do that. Marinated the chicken. And I'm going to just give dum to this now with burnt coal. Pour some oil over it and cover it immediately. And let it sit around until we get the gravy done.
And also 3 teaspoons of salt to the marinade.
For the basic gravy for the butter chicken, I'm going to start with 1 tablespoon of oil, which is already heating. And I've taken about 1 1/2 big size onion, which we're just going to soften it. You're not going to brown it at all. That's what we want, and we're going to grind this later on. It will take over at least 5 minutes for this onion to get softened. And then I'll show you the next step.
So now the onions have slightly translucent. You can see they've gotten a little translucent now. It's been exactly 5 minutes that I was sauteing them.
You don't want to go them brown at all. To this stage, I'm going to add about 10 to 12 cloves of garlic and about 2 inches of ginger and 3 green chilies. You're just going to soften all of these ingredients, and I'm going to add some khada masala, which is 3 bay leaves, 3 small pieces of cinnamon, about 6 to 7 cloves, 5 green cardamom, and about 12 to 13 peppercorns. Whole peppercorns. So you're just going to soften this ingredients now. You're just going to saute it. So nice aroma will come out of the garam masala. To this I'm going to add, I've taken about 3/4 cups of tukda kaju or broken cashew nuts. You don't have to have good quality big ones, because that you are going to anyways make paste of it. So just tukda kaju would work. About 3/4 cup full. And the same gravy, you can put different ingredients. It's a very universal gravy. You can use paneer butter masala with the same thing, or when you're making your kofta curry also, you could use same base gravy. And to this I'm going to add now 3 red tomatoes, which are sliced. And you don't have to worry about slicing them, you know, finely chopped or anything, because you're going to grind them anyway. So at this stage, our tomatoes are nicely softened, you can see. And the onions are also nicely softened. Now I'm going to turn off the heat and let it cool down the mixture. And I'm going to grind it through the mixer grinder now. And that's our base gravy for our butter chicken. And in the meantime, we'll start cooking the chicken on a grill pan. As I showed you, I had given dum to the tikka pieces that we're going to use for our butter chicken. And it's been about almost 45 minutes to an hour. Longer you marinate, better the flavor is going to be. So now I'm going to start putting these on the skewers. I had soaked the skewers for about hour or two so that they won't get burned when we are cooking it on the griddle. So slowly we're going to start putting this on our skewers now. My skewers are done. I'm going to start putting all the pieces on my skewers. And we are going to cook this on a griddle. You can always put it in the oven also, at, as I told you, 350 degrees Fahrenheit.
or 180 degrees Celsius for about 20-25 minutes. They should be done. Now you can see all my skewers are ready, and I'm going to put them on the hot griddle. Use a griddle with the, you know, the lines, so that it will have that charred mark on your kebabs basically. This is a mixture of the base gravy that I'm making now, and I'm going to add about 3 teaspoons of Kashmiri red chili powder to this. Okay, and I'm going to grind this into smooth paste. And that is going to be our gravy base for our butter chicken. Now that our skewers are ready, I'm going to cook them on the griddle. The griddle has a nice marking on it, so our skewers are going to have nice grill marks. Put it on medium flame now. Cook evenly on every side, and these are the pieces, kebab pieces, of we're going to add it to our butter chicken. So now you can see one side is nicely charred, how the tikkas are looking. That's how you want all the grill marks and nice charred mark on your tikkas. Look at that. It's been 7 minutes that I cooked on one side, so I'm turning it over now. Another 7 minutes on this side, so that it's completely, it will get cooked on this side, and then I'm going to turn it over sideways also. And make sure the flame is a little bit on medium to high, so that you don't want that liquid to be there in the pan. It will get nicely absorbed into the chicken tikkas. So now it's been 5 minutes on the other side. You can see they're nice charred mark on this as well, and I'm going to turn it over on this side like so. Let's check on marks. It still needs a little bit more, so I'm going to just leave it like that. Look at the charred marks nicely. I'm going to turn it over on this side now. If you want, drizzle some oil in between, maybe a teaspoon or so, and let it cook on the other side as well now. The meat is already falling off, so it's completely cooked now. Likewise, I'm going to get all our chicken tikkas ready. So now we're going to work on our gravy now. I've taken about 1.5 tablespoons of oil. To that, I'm adding about 3 tablespoons of butter. To that, I'm going to add our gravy that we made. Now mix it up and butter chicken. So to the oil and butter mixture, I've added the mixture that we had ground for our butter chicken gravy. I've just rinsed the mixer jar with the water a little bit, because the gravy is very rich and thick. As you can see, let it simmer for a couple of minutes now. Let it get nicely bhunofied. Make sure you cover the lid, because it's going to splutter the gravy now. So be careful, it might splash on you, so just put it on low to medium flame. Chicken tikka pieces to this now. I'm adding 2 teaspoons of sugar to this, because butter chicken gravy is a little bit sweeter taste. So taste something like this. I'm just going to add some kasuri methi on top of it. I'm just going to add a tablespoon, couple of tablespoons of fresh cream. So it will make nice rich gravy. Let it simmer for about 15-20 minutes. And you can serve it with garma garam naan, garlic naan, or jeera rice, whatever you prefer. And enjoy your butter chicken. Now butter chicken is ready to be served. The recipe is in the description box below. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Heart to Palate.